everybody, welcome to my channel. My name is Kemi. Welcome to my channel. This video, I'm just going to be testing out two products that I received from Influencer and MAC Cosmetics, and that is what I used to create this look. And it is a new product by MAC. This is called MAC Studio Radiance Serum Powered Foundation. I was matched to the shade NW50. This is supposed to be a very hydrating, give you a radiant look, give you a, you know, that my skin is being taken care of kind of look. And they also sent me the Fix Plus, Matte Fix Plus setting spray. And what I really like about this spray is how very, like, tiny the mist is. It's very misty. It's not like spitting in your face, it's more like, ooh, I could just do this all day kind of spray. The eyeshadow is Dubious Place. I'm gonna show everything in this video, so I really hope that you enjoy it. Usually I would do my brows and my shadow, and then I would proceed to doing the rest of the face. But I just really wanted to see what, I guess it doesn't really make a difference. I'm just opening it for the first time. So I was sent this by Influencer and MAC, and I am going to be trying this for the first time. I think a lot more people are paying more attention to the health of their skin, because a lot of us are wearing makeup more often, and it is always important to keep the skin in good condition, because you can cover and cover and cover up, but when you take off the makeup, you need to have something healthy to go back to. So I think that this is a brilliant new product. Today I use my vitamin C serum, and then I've toned with rose water and glycerin, and then I've gone in with my moisturizer. Always good to have skincare incorporated into makeup, especially for those who wear it on a daily. Okay, so that's me just saying my own. This is a setting spray, and this is a supposedly the mini size, and this is the Studio Radiance. I'm using the Blur and Smooth primer today. Just gonna let that dry. So I do understand that the Studio Radiance is supposed to be give more of a dewy finish. Well, it's not matte, because it's supposed to be like glowy and hydrating, so it should give like a softer look than like matte finishes. I'm going to use the Maybelline foundation just as a slightly lighter kind of a highlight. I think I will go in with a little bit of that concealer. It's still a foundation. I think that the good thing with doing the whole face before the eyes is when I'm applying the concealer or anything under my eyes, I can really just be a bit more not concise with it. Like, I can go on top of my lids and try to make sure everything's blended, as opposed to doing the eyes first, and then you kind of have to avoid coming onto the eyes. So I'm going in with a sort of pink. It's a lipstick from a lipstick palette. So I'm going to set under my eyes with where is it? It's the LA Girl Pro powder, setting powder. And I'm just going to use this and tap that under my eye. If it's too bright, I will go in with another LA Girl Pro, but this is a pressed powder. I will go in with a slightly darker color. Start from the edge of the highlighter. And now I'm going to go in with just all over the face powder. And I really like this, because you can really just be a mixologist and just go in all the different colors. And if you make a mistake, you don't have to put one down and open another one. So I really like having everything in one hand. Now I'm going to go into L'Oreal Infallible 24 Hours powder, foundation powder, as my bronzer. We're just going to do what we need to do. So I'm going to push it into my natural contour area. I see why people can go overboard with bronzing, because it's like after all the light, all the flat powder and everything, it just kind of starts to bring color back into your face, and people can just really go crazy with bronzing. So I do not have my blush, like a powder blush right now. So I'm going to try and use this color from Juvia's Place. It's called the Bronzed Rustic. Is this one instead? This is the Nubian 2. And that's got these colors in there. So I usually use this one as to deepen the crease. And then back into my bronzing blush, brush. And then I'm just going to stamp in there. I'm gonna pull it down a little bit. I wanna blend. And then I'm gonna go into the Bronzed Rustic. Is this color here? My face here. I think that's it. I think I need it down here. I'm just there. Okay, I'm going to set this. So that's concealer I'm just using to base the shadow. I'm just going to let that dry at the back. Okay, so I think I'm going to try to use this today. We're just going to keep it almost kind of neutral. I'm going to go into my crease with this color. Now, should I use this yellow or should I use this yellow over this yellow, yellow under? Of course, I'm going to go with the yellow. It's like a mustard yellow, kind of almost orange. Okay, so I'm going to just use a touch of this. Actually, it has some pigment to it. I thought it was like very, very light and sheer, but they said no. Trying to discount me or something. I don't know where I paused, but I was just applying the black shadow. I didn't realize I wasn't recording this whole time. I think I have plenty on this side. Just about done there. Okay, so now I'm going to do my lashes. They're a little wonky, but we will move on. So I'm going into this the shimmer shade in here. It's like a bronze. Into the inner tear dot corner. So I'm going to line my eyes, my under eyes, with this white. It's a cream colour. I can't find like my coloured pencils. So I really don't have bottom lashes, so sometimes that's a waste of time. And I'm going to just finish up with the lips. Back into the MAC Fix Plus setting spray and give this one final mist. Yes, my review right now is that it is lightweight, it's buildable, and it's supposed to be radiating, it's supposed to be hydrating, so it definitely I didn't get that mattifying finish from it, that's what it's supposed to do. My skin is on the oily side, so radiant glow is good, but I also have to make sure to use my powders to keep everything sane, and also have to use a mattifying primer, which I didn't necessarily use, just so that it doesn't mess too much with the foundation. Hydration is important, and I think that healthy skin is important to be considered by makeup companies. And so that's the vibes I'm getting from this, right? And it says 209% more hydrated skin instantly, 24-hour hydration, 80% skincare base with hyaluronic acid. It's medium buildable coverage, radiant glow finish, 12-hour wear, transfer resistant, non-creasing, non-caking, does not clog pores. I literally just read this because I was looking for, like, where does it say how it's serum powered, and I just really literally just based my review on just using it, and I definitely felt that it's a more hydrating formula and medium coverage, like I said, and this has got hyaluronic acid in it. So obviously, like, we know that everyone wants glowy skin, we all want, like, naturally looking radiant skin these days, and I think that a lot more people are taking more serious care about their skin, being more intentional about picking up products that have hydrating formulation. It's just the best because, like, we layer all these things before the foundation, and I think it's such a great idea to actually have all of that still incorporated in the makeup, in the foundation. So yeah, thumbs up for that, thumbs up Mac for that, and I hope that you enjoyed how I created this look. That is my review. I enjoyed using that setting spray, it was just so good. I would just, like, take it everywhere and just keep setting, whether I have makeup or not. It's just so soft, like, it was just, like, misty, very misty. The Mac Studio, it does say it's 12-hour wear, so don't expect it to stay on for 24 hours or whatever. It's a 12-hour wear, medium coverage, so you can expect that if you are on the oily side, I'm gonna expect I'm gonna start shining a little bit more, but I just know that I feel hydrated because I know that I've done my skincare, my hydrating skincare, and then I followed up with my hydrating foundation. So I think that is a plus on every side. Anyways, that is it. So this is the look. We are glowing and radiating, like, we are so successful in life. And we are given bronze, giving rustic, giving coral, giving soft and edgy, with the asymmetric bob, edgy with the blonde tips, soft with the cheeks, soft with the skin. Hope you like this video. Don't forget to check out my previous videos. Let me know what you think. And don't forget to subscribe and join the channel of goodies. And I'll talk to you guys again in my next one. Lift my heart up when the rest of me is down. You enchant me even when you're not around.